¿Qué onda, mijitos? ¿Cómo están?
Di hola.
Hola. ¿Qué es?
No, it's fine. ¿Qué onda, mijitos? Oigan, como ya ven el título de este video, la intención de este video es mostrarles una pequeña parte de mi vida, porque siento que se las tengo que compartir, ya que ustedes han estado apoyándome casi siempre y pues la verdad es que siento que, bueno, tenía ganas de hacerlo. Y bueno, este video, aquí les voy a dejar el link de nuestro nuevo canal que vamos a hacer juntos, porque como pueden ver, bueno, no... Bueno, Casey no habla español. Entonces, hasta que aprenda, vamos a hacer estos videos en inglés. So, this is our first new YouTube video.
Yes.
So as you can see in the title, this is my new boyfriend, Casey. Casey,
what's up, guys?
Tell us about you.
I am from Hawaii, from Maui, Hawaii. And I live in Portland now, in Oregon.
Yeah, try to watch the camera.
Okay. Sorry, guys, this is my first time. I'm not really good at this whole YouTube thing. But yeah, I've lived in Portland for like a year now. When I left Hawaii, I came over here and I bought a van and I road tripped for maybe like 6 months throughout the summer and then ended up settling down here in Portland. I have a dog. That's pretty cute.
Yeah, where is
she? She lives here. Indica.
Come on. Come here.
Indica. Hi, baby. This
She's
is Indica.
Here. Come on.
Indica.
She's here.
She's so pretty.
Yeah, so basically Casey, he's a cool guy and we met. You want to tell a story about how we met?
I guess so. 4 months ago now, I was down in Tulum with a couple friends, just doing like a little trip. And we went to this party. We had gotten tickets to this party and it was pretty expensive. But my friend had like bought tickets earlier. And so we were like, all right, we gotta go. So we went to this party and we got there and the general admission tickets that we had, like we got into the area and it was just completely like super shitty. And so me and my friends were like, okay, we need to get into VIP. Like we saw the VIP was on the other side and it looked way nicer. It was like actually on the beach and had like, it was just way nicer. So I was like, okay, we need to get VIP. So we kind of went and saw this little area and decided to like sneak into VIP. So we snuck into VIP, made it all right. We're chilling. We went and found this little bed to lay on. So we're laying on the bed and then I look over and this guy's sitting there and I didn't know who he was at the time, but like we started talking to his friends.
Yeah, actually you talked to my friends first.
Oh, okay. We start talking to his friends first, I think. Yeah. And then he ended up coming over later, I guess.
Yeah, because I was around like with another people and then I saw my friends with them and I just started close and we start talking and start meeting each other and it was it was kind of cool. It was interesting. Then we become that night then we became really good friends.
Yeah, super drunk together and hung out all night on the beach.
Yeah, we were super drunk. We were dancing. I mean, it was a festival. It wasn't a festival.
It was more of like a
beach club party. Yeah, exactly. It was pretty fun. I had blackout that night. I was sleeping.
I blacked out too
in one of the
day bed thing. Yeah. The beds at the beach. I don't know.
Yeah, that one. So yeah, it was a mess. And then you gave me your Instagram and your friend's Instagram. So yeah, the next day we were chilling. I was chilling with my friends. So I text him like, if you wanna go out, you wanna do something. I mean, we're chilling. But he was like,
I was out. I had parties to go to. I was doing my thing. I was so busy out there. But yeah, we like kept in contact after that. So then the next chapter.
So then I text you and invite you to come to Mexico City.
Yeah,
it was pretty dope. I mean, we spent like one whole week.
It was a week, I think. Yeah.
So he came to Mexico City for his first time. I was really excited to show him around. I think it was a good host.
He was a really good host. He was super cool, guys.
Yeah. I mean, I try to be a good host, even more in my country, because I really love to share my culture, my city, things around me, my friends. I really love to do that. I don't know.
Yeah. It was sweet. He was awesome. Like, I got to see a lot while we were out there. We went to like a cool festival.
Ah, Baidora. Baidora is like a super cool festival in Las Estacas, Morelos, like a town close to Mexico City.
It was crazy. It was super pretty out there and that was a fun few days. And yeah, so I spent a week out there and then came back to Oregon. I was chilling here. So we were kind of like, okay, once you go to LA, we can meet up again. You know, it's not too far.
I went to LA and I was there like for 4 days. I spent 4 days in LA, right?
I really need to get water.
I need to go back. Well, I was in LA for 4 days and then I asked him like, bro, so this problem about COVID-19 and quarantine, I was really scared about it and I was in LA pretty alone, so I was feeling like really lonely. And then I text him and say, hey bro, can I come to your place and we can do a road trip, because I knew that he had a van. I heard that Oregon was an amazing stay for the road trip. So then I text you.
You texted me and you were like, can I come in like 2 days and go on a road
trip.
And so I was like, yes, let's go. Come on, I'm ready. So I set up the van and then he came on over and I picked him up at the airport.
Yeah.
What? That was like a week ago.
2 weeks ago.
No.
Yeah. 2 weeks. I spent 2 weeks here.
There's no way.
Yeah, I arrived on Monday, the last week.
Anyway. Anyway.
So I spent with him the best weeks ever.
It was super sick.
It was super cool. I'm gonna leave you the picture here that we took on that trip. These hot springs are in Idaho and this waterfall is in Oregon. These hot springs are in Oregon. So yeah, I really fell in love with this guy.
I mean, oh my god. Wow, that was quick, guys.
I mean, yeah, I mean, I think we like each other, we have a good chemistry. Oh, and tell him about the proposal. How was the proposal?
Oh,
so I'm gonna add the picture here.
The proposal.
The proposal. Like, and you say they don't believe about that, right?
I have never heard of this proposal. I mean,
that's
proposal
crazy.
Proposal is for marriage, obviously.
No, in Mexico, you definitely have to ask someone if that person wants to date with you. That's really important. Because how do you know that you are...
Comment like, down below if that is true.
No, but...
I've never heard of
listen,
this.
Listen, how do you know that you are like dating for real?
I mean, I would say like you just kind of know, like after a bit, after it, you know, it just kind of happens. I don't know. It's always happened like more organic. I don't know. I've never heard of this proposal. Anyway, it was a new concept for me. But,
but you did at the end.
I decided to get creative. And so it was pretty lit. Did you like it?
I was obsessed. Yeah. I was kind of crying when I saw it. He told me like look, watch out.
Watch out. What's that?
And yeah, it was super fun. I really love it. And
oh my gosh. Yeah, it was really cute.
So I said, yes, for sure, I want to be your boyfriend. I mean, this is kind of crazy because he's my first boyfriend. I never had a boyfriend before. I don't know how to deal with that. I don't know how I don't know. It's kind of crazy. Tell me you about how relationships are.
Oh my god.
How this shit works.
Relationships are a tricky thing. What do you want me to say?
I mean, I don't know. That's the best part about a relationship, that you have to go with the flow, enjoy it, share moments, share experiences with another person. Like, I feel, I mean, I don't see Casey as my boyfriend. I don't think like he belongs to me. I think I've seen more like a really amazing friend, like a cool friend, someone I can really trust, someone I can hang out easily.
For sure.
And I can tell him anything. These four past months have been really, really cool with him. So yeah, that's how I feel now, and I'm pretty sure that more things are coming for us. We are really trying to do like cute stuff for you guys, so I hope you like it. And yeah, so that was
I think everybody's relationships are different and kind of just depends on what works for you and who makes you happy. And you know, you just gotta spend time with people that make you happy and make you a better person.
That's true.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll be telling you more stuff in the next video. So guys, if this is the first time you are watching us, please subscribe, give a like, and share with your friends if you like it. You can follow us on our Instagram. So I'm gonna leave your Instagram here, my Instagram here, and we have a new account that we create together.
Yes, we're gonna have to make some videos for you guys. We're really excited. So stay tuned.
You're gonna love us. So yeah. So yes. Of course. I'm gonna teach him Spanish in the next few days. He's gonna
days. Yeah. Maybe. Maybe over the next few years, guys. I'll get there. We're gonna start practicing for sure. But you know, we'll do our best.
Yeah.
I do have a lot of time, I guess, now that this quarantine.
Yeah.
You can do like.
So guys, stay safe. By the way, it's really hard.
Yeah, it's scary out there. Get yourself some hand sanitizer if you can. Steal some toilet paper. If you need toilet paper, take it from, I was gonna say restaurants, but restaurants are closed.
Yeah, everything is closed. It's really scary. So yeah, guys. So yeah, hope you like it and cheers.